Manuel Guzmán, I'm a full professor of biochemistry and molecular biology at Complutense University in Madrid, and the major focus of my research, the same as our whole lab's research, is trying to identify the mechanisms by which cannabinoids, the active components of cannabis, act in our body, and more precisely trying to find potential therapeutic applications of cannabinoids in the fields of oncology and neurodegeneration. When we talk about cancer is a very heterogeneous disease. There are more than 200 different types of cancer that are clearly typified by the World Health Organization, and there are many more types of cancer that are still not typified. I would say that every cancer is individual. Nowadays, I think we have a relatively good knowledge on how cannabinoids act in mice and rats that harbor different types of tumors, but unfortunately, we know very little about how cannabinoids may affect tumor growth in cancer patients. So that is clearly the pending question in this field. Cannabinoids are promising, but are they really good compounds for treating patients with cancer? We don't know as yet.
So what we are doing here is we have a lot of cancer cells, actually human glioma cell lines that are in culture, so we are culturing them in these plastic containers. So we have to grow them before injecting them in the mice to generate tumors.
How long does it take to actually grow a cancer cell or culture them?
They are growing quite fast, but it depends on the number of cells that you put in each of the containers. Maybe you could have up to 7 million cells per plate. And normally we inject between 5 and 10 million cells per animal. So you need to grow a lot of plates in order to get enough. But they take maybe 3 days to grow.
Right.
And then once you have the cells, let's say floating, then you can inject them. But that's similar to what happens, for instance, with a metastasis or a tumor that is generated. Cells have to deattach from the original tumor, migrate through the bloodstream, and then reach into the tissue where the tumor is going to be generated. So this is trying to simulate a little bit what's happening in a human tumor. And now we can go and see whether treatment with cannabinoids or other combinations can reduce tumor size or at least can avoid tumor growth.
If you have a tumor that has different types of weapons to fight against the body, it is clear that the body needs different types of weapons or different types of protections against the tumor. That means that when one is dealing with chemotherapies or overall with therapies against tumors, it's very naive to think that for treating a very malignant tumors that have very different mutations and therefore very different processes to fight against the body, that using just one weapon will be effective. We need different weapons. Different weapons in chemotherapy means equals different compounds with different mechanisms of actions. I mean, targeting different receptors and targeting different processes of the malignant cells. And that is at the end what we do when we do drug cocktails. On the one hand, TAC has a particular mechanism of action. It binds cannabinoid receptors and therefore it triggers within the cell a process of cell death, of programmed cell death. We have a second weapon, that is CBD, that does not bind with high affinity to cannabinoid receptors. It is usually called cannabinoid because it's in the cannabis plant, but from the pharmacological point of view, it's not a cannabinoid because it doesn't bind cannabinoid receptors.
I thought there was some affinity between the CB2 receptor.
It has a little bit of affinity, but overall we don't believe, at least in our preclinical experiments with cancer cells, we do not believe that it exerts at least most of its effect via cannabinoid receptors. So most of it, what CBD does, overcomes cannabinoid receptors. That means that it's using a different weapon a different avenue, a different manner to target cancer cells. It induces cancer cell death as well, but via different, say, road, by different avenue, with a different mechanism. And third, we have temozolomide. Temozolomide kills glioma cells by using a different mechanism. Temozolomide doesn't bind cannabinoid receptors, of course, it's not a cannabinoid. It creates alteration in DNA, in the genetic material, that distorts DNA structure so that the cell reacts against that distortion, that mutation that temozolomide makes in the DNA, in the genetic material of the cell, by blocking proliferation so that that mutation does not go to the daughter cells, and then most of the times by killing, by inducing the suicide of that mutated cell. So at the end, if we combine three compounds, in this case THC, CBD and temozolomide, we have three different manners of targeting, three different ways of targeting different mutations, different processes of the cancer cell.
Different combinations of different cancers seems to be coming through.
At least in our hands, CBD never worked so well in glioma. So it does something, but it doesn't do as much as THC or THC CBD 1-1.
So in gliomas, THC is really important.
Yeah.
Really important.
And then the other thing is that in terms of going for therapy, as we were also discussing previous visits, probably the combination with other chemotherapeutic agents that are already being administered to the patient is important. So our idea is that CBD doesn't combine so well with other compounds, whereas THC does it well, and the THC CBD 1-1 does it well. So that's what we want to check in this experiment, because if we see that, for instance, the 1-1 plus temozolomide works clearly better than the 1-9 plus temozolomide, or even imagine that the 1-1 and 1-9 work the same way, the 1-9 works better, but it doesn't combine well with temozolomide. Maybe in terms of going for a real therapy, patients seem to be much likely to go for a combination, and probably it's going to be more effective at the end of the day.
Can cannabinoids cure cancer, or can cannabinoids inhibit tumor growth? Depends on what type of tumor. I mean, so far there is no therapy at all that is effective for all types of cancer. There are some therapies that work relatively fine in precise types of cancers. So that is one of the first questions. I mean, not only whether, the first question, of course, whether cannabinoid can be promising in treating cancer, but I would add, which types of cancer? We first would have to try to define which types of cancer are really prone to be treated with cannabinoids, because I expect that there will be some that may be sensitive to cannabinoids, but there will be others that will not.